For patients that I often see are Chinese speaking, but I cannot say that they are all the same because that they come from different countries. They have different story behind them. Some they were refugees before, some they gone through the wartime, some they are for different reasons that come to Canada. But I find that sometimes it's interesting that their social support is reduced because of moving to Canada. So in terms that when they get sick, they will find it, oh, I don't have many people that can help me or support me. Family is a very important within the Chinese community because whenever we have problems, we have difficulties, we seek help within our family first rather than going out to ask for support. Self-reliance is a really strong concept within the Chinese community. They often say it as "靠自己," don't bother other people. So that also make them that they are a bit reluctant to seek help from outside. Just like booking a volunteer driver service, they will say that, well, maybe I will leave it to those people really in need, and maybe I would take bus to come for the treatment. They don't feel that they are really in need, so they will feel that, well, let other people use first. But when I explain to them that, yeah, sometimes that maybe you don't know that whether people sitting next to you, they have a cold or cough that you may get infected, right? Because when you are receiving treatment, that your immune system that being affected. So I would encourage them that maybe take the volunteer driver or get some friend to help you. Then they will feel that, oh, I don't want to bother other people.